Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to take up design of helical springs. I think you are able to see this spring. I have a helical spring here. This spring here is called as the helical spring. We get a problem in which this has to be designed. Its dimensions have to be found out. You will get a problem for about say 10 marks, 8 to 10 marks. Okay. Now, first, what are the different types of springs that we have? Some theory I will tell. What are the types of springs we have? We have helical springs, leaf springs, spiral springs, etc. These are the different types of springs. I think you have seen this type of spring in spring balance. It is in spring balance, it will be subjected to a tensile load. Here, this is subjected to a compression. This is called a compression helical spring. This type of springs very big in size. You can find under railway carriages. You see smaller size springs of this nature in your ball pens, where you have this thing. In cycle stand, you have this type of springs. To lock the stand of the cycle, you use this. So, like this, they are used in various places. In clocks, we have spiral springs. In the trucks, you might have seen leaf springs in suspension. So, these are the different types of springs that are used. Now, they are used for different purposes, like to measure the load. Like in spring balance, the spring is used to measure the load. In to support a load. In compression springs are used to support a load like this, to absorb shocks. In shock absorbers of vehicle, we use springs. To store kinetic energy, we use any energy can be stored in this, like we do in watches. So springs are used for different purposes and different materials are used. You are supposed to know what are the different materials that are used. Now here what we have to find out mainly is small d, design of helical springs. Here W is the axial load in Newton. That is the load that we apply. When you apply a load, this undergoes a deflection, delta. Delta is the deflection, that is how much its length increases or decreases in millimeters. If it is a tensile load, the length will increase. If it is compressive load, the length will decrease. So that is called as deflection. Next, small d is dia of wire from which this spring is made. Capital D is mean coil dia in mm. That is the mean dia from the center of the this thing to center. What is the mean dia? That is called D is mean dia of the coil. Then D by D, ratio of mean dia to wire dia, this is called as spring index. This is denoted by C. This has no unit. Spring index is D by D. Then this N means, or I, in some books it is given as I, it is number of active coils, means excluding the topmost coil and the bottommost coil. The coils in the middle are called as active coils. They are the coils which take load. N dash is total number of coils. This will be always N plus 2. That is one coil at the top, extra coil at the top and extra coil at the bottom. N dash. Then we have this thing tau, that is permissible shear stress. shear stress of the material of the wire from which the spring is made, of wire material. It is in Newton per mm square. In Newton per mm square, then we have G, modulus of rigidity, modulus of rigidity in Newton per mm square. Then we have K, which is called Wall's stress factor, stress factor. This is given as 4C minus 1 divided by 4C minus 4 plus 0.615 divided by C, where C is this spring index which will be given. Then this will be given. Generally, what we have to find out is, we have to find out this, this and this. Given other quantities, we will have to find out this. Now, this Wall's stress factor is, see, we say this tau is the permissible shear stress of the wire material from which the spring is made. Now, that stress that we find out is when the wire is straight. Wire is straight, it is subjected to a test and we find out what is the permissible shear stress. But it is bent now, it is wound in a helical shape, in a helical shape, and this is tempered. So after that, that stress will be lesser. So it is tau divided by K, that is its value. The value of K is always greater than 1. Tau by K will give you, if you take stress concentration into effect, you have to divide this tau by a factor called Wall's stress factor, which is known as K. Now, the formula that we use, or one formula that we use, is tau is equal to K into 8WC divided by pi d square. Now, this formula we use, this formula we can derive from the torsion equation. When you apply an axial load on this, what happens is this material of the wire will be subjected to twisting or torsion. So from there we can get this formula. By applying this formula, we'll get this. Here this will be given, this will be given, this will be given, directly or indirectly. So if you know all these quantities, we can get D from here. This is one formula which is important. Then the second important formula is, once you get this small d, capital D will be C into D. C is given, so you will get this. Second important formula is deflection delta is 8 W C cube N divided by G into D to the GD. This is the formula. So if you know delta, W, C, G and D, D we will get here. So we can get N, number of active coils. Then N dash will be equal to N plus 2, N plus 2, that you can find out. Then you can find out the solid length. Solid length means, if it is fully compressed such that there is no gap between one coil and another coil, the length of the spring at that time is called as the solid length. So solid length, you can call it as LS or some other name what they give. This will be N dash D. Then free length. Free length means the length of the spring when it is no load is acting on it, what is its length? That is called as the free length. This will be solid length plus maximum deflection we want plus clearance. Clearance will be usually 1 mm, N dash minus 1 into 1. That will give you the free length. It is denoted as LF. Then pitch of coils, that is distance between one coil and another coil, will be LF divided by n dash minus 1 plus d, or any other formula which is given can be used in your this thing. So these formulae will be given. We have to find out these things. Normally these things are to be found out. We have to find out small d, capital D, n, n dash, ls, lf, and pitch of the coil. Pitch means this one. Then some more definitions are there, like stiffness of the spring, that is defined as deflection per unit, load per unit deflection is called as the stiffness. So it will be mathematically the ratio of load, axial load to deflection will give you the stiffness of the spring. So these, they can be asked in theory, these definitions, what is the spring index, what is free length, what is solid length, what is stiffness of the spring, or stiffness is also called as rate of the spring. They can ask these things. Now we will take up a few simple problems here from the question bank and try to solve them. Okay, now I'll take problem number 4. Design a helical compression spring for a maximum load of 1000 newton. Design a compression helical spring for a maximum load of axial load of 1000 newton. That means W is directly given here. It will be given either directly or it can be given indirectly. W is 1000 newton. Now deflection under this load is 25 mm. Delta is given 25 mm. The value of spring index is 5, that is C is 5. The maximum permissible shear stress tau is 420 MPa, 420 MPa, or 420 N/mm². Modulus of rigidity, that is G, is 84 kN/mm. It has to be converted into Newton per square mm. So 84,000 N/mm². Then considering Wall's factor, that is take K into consideration. So now first we will use this formula. This is the formula. So D will be equal to under root K into 8 WC divided by pi into tau. So I know W, I know C, I know tau. What I don't know is K. K can be got from this formula, 4C minus 1 divided by 4C minus 4 plus 0.615 divided by C. That is 4 into 5 minus 1, 4 into 5 minus 4. Plus 0.615 divided by 5. So this is 20 minus 1, 19 by 20 minus 4, 16, plus 0.615 divided by 5. So 19 divided by 16, 16 plus 19 divided by 16 plus 0.615 divided by 5, that is 1.31. usually its value is just above 1, it will be more than 1. So this will be root of 1.31 into 8 into W is 1000 into C is 5 divided by pi into this is 420 under root 1.31 into 8 into 1000 into 5 divided by pi divided by 420. I got that 39 point something. Square root of answer gives me 6.3 mm. 6.3 6.3 mm, that is the dia of the wire from which the spring is to be made. If you have standard table, SWG table, standard wire gauge table, you can select the answer from there, next size available, or adopt D is equal to say 7 or even 8 mm you can take, no problem. You can take a little extra, there is no problem. Then capital D is C into D, that is 5 into 8, 40 mm, mean dia of the spring. Then use this formula and get N from here. So N will be equal to, delta into G into D divided by 8 WC cube, delta into G into D divided by 8 WC cube. Delta is 25, G is 84 followed by 3 zeros, D is, we have taken it as 8 divided by 8 into C cube, that is 5 cube into, that's it, sorry, 8 into 5 cube into W is 1000. I will missed out W there. 8 WC cube. So 8 into W is 1000 into C cube is 5 cube. So 25 into 84,000 into 8 divided by 8 divided by 1000 divided by 5 to the power of 3, 16.8 turns or coils. These are the number of active coils. Say 18 coils, you can take it as 18 coils or 18 turns. So N dash will be equal to 18 plus 2, that will be 20 coils. Now solid length LS is N dash D, that is 20 into 8, right? N dash D, 20 into 8, 160 mm. Then free length will be solid length plus maximum deflection. There is only one deflection here, plus N dash minus 1 into 1. That is solid length is 160 plus maximum deflection is only 1. That is 25 plus N dash is 20 minus 1. That is 19 into 1 is 19 only. So 160 plus 25 plus 19 gives me 204 mm. Pitch will be LF divided by N dash minus 1 plus D, that is 204 divided by 20 minus 1, that is 19 plus 8. 204 divided by 19 equals 10 point something plus 8, that is 18.73 mm. That's the problem. It carries about 8 to 10 marks. One more. We'll take up one more problem. Problem number 2. There are only 4 problems given here. We'll take up problem number 2. Design the spring of a valve for a petrol engine from the following. Spring load when the valve is open, that is maximum load, is 400 newton. Maximum load is 400 newton. spring load when the valve is closed. That is the minimum load. So we can call this as W2, this is W1, this is 250. Or they will say the load is varying from 250 Newton to 400 Newton. Next, maximum inside diameter. Inside diameter is D minus D. Will give the inside diameter, that is 25 mm. D minus D is 25 mm. Then length of the spring when the valve is open. Length of spring when valve is open is 40 mm. Length of spring when the valve is closed is 50 mm. Maximum permissible shear stress, that is tau, is 400 megapascal. They have not given G. We can assume it as 84,000 Newton per mm square. Usually it is between 80,000 Newton per mm square to this thing. We have to design the spring means find D, D and N. These are the major things that you have to find out. Here the spring index is not given. So we will neglect this thing. See, the load is, first it is 250 Newton. This is the minimum load. Maximum load is 400. That means when the load changes from 250 to 400, it undergoes a deflection. That deflection, when it is here it is 50 mm, then it becomes 40 mm. That means the deflection is LO minus LC, that is 50 minus 40, that is 10 mm for a load range of 150 Newton. W will be W2 minus W1, that is 400 minus 250, that is 150 Newton. When the load varies by 150 Newton, the deflection undergone is 10 mm. So this is called W and this thing. Now I have assumed this is not given, we have assumed this. So what I will do is, first I have to find out the diameter, this small d, diameter of the wire. For that I will use the formula tau is equal to 8WC divided by pi d square. In the previous problem I had used K. Here I cannot use K because K I cannot get because C is not given. Right. So R I'll have to assume C. Here it is not given. C I will assume as 5 or 6. Anything you can assume, it will be 5, 6, 7, something like that. We will assume this. So D will be equal to under root 8WC divided by pi into tau. So it will be 8. Here you have to take maximum load, that is W2. W2 is 400. It has to withstand the maximum load. I have taken C assumed as 6 divided by pi into tau is given as 400. So 48 by pi. This 400 goes means 48 divided by pi will give me this much. Square root of answer gives me 3.9 mm. Say 4 mm. Now capital D will be 25 plus D, that is 25 plus 4, that is 29 mm. Now C will be 29 by 4, 7.25. I had assumed it as 6, but it is 7.25. Okay, it doesn't matter. Next, you have to find out N. n delta is equal to 8 w c cube n divided by g d. So n will be equal to delta into g into d divided by 8 w c cube. So delta is 10 mm for a load range of 150 mm into g is 84 followed by 3 zeros, d we have got as 4 mm divided by 8 into w is 150 into c cube 6 cube. So it will be 10 into 84,000 into 4 divided by 8 divided by 150 divided by 6 to the power of 3. I am getting 12.96 mm, no, sorry, coils. 12.96 coils. We can take it as 14 coils. Say 14 coils or 14 tons. Then n dash will be n plus 2, that will be 16 coils. Then n dash plus c, the 2, 16 coils. Solid length of the spring will be n dash into d, that is 16 into 4, 64 mm. Now maximum deflection, delta max, will be equal to w by delta into w2. Delta by w, because delta by w is equal to delta max by w max. W max is this load. So for if the deflection for a variation of 150 newton is 10 mm, what is the deflection when the load is 400 newton? So 10 by 250 into 400. That will give me the deflection, maximum deflection. I think 10 into 400 divided by 250. That will give me a deflection of 16 mm, that is maximum deflection, delta max. So free length will be, LS, solid length plus delta max plus n dash minus 1 into 1, minimum clearance. This is 64 plus 16 plus this is 16 minus 1, that is 15. This thing, 64 plus 16 plus, that will work out to 15. That will be 95 mm free length. Then you can find out the pitch. LF divided by n dash minus 1 plus d. LF is 95 divided by 16 minus 1 plus d is 4 mm. 95 by 15, 95 divided by 15 plus 4, that will be 10.3 mm. So that completes this problem. We have done two problems. There are only four problems given here, four or five. Four. You can do the remaining problems. I think you have understood it. If any doubts are there, you can clarify, you can give your comments on this, and I shall be very glad to reply to you. Thank you.